In this lesson, we're going to go into AWS Config and we're going to create a rule that checks whether an S3 bucket has server-side encryption enabled. And if it doesn't, then we're going to set up auto-remediation to enable server-side encryption. So let's head over to the console. In AWS, I'm going to go to Services, and under Management and Governance here, we've got Config. On the dashboard here, we can see we already have an inventory of the resources we have in our account, but we don't have any rules yet. So let's go and create a rule. On the rules page, I'm going to click on add rule. We're going to use an AWS manage rule. I'm going to search for S3 and go to the fourth page of the search results. Here we've got this manage rule, S3 bucket server side encryption enabled. And this is going to check that we have server side encryption enabled on our bucket. So I'm going to select that option, choose next. It's going to give it a default name. Now what I'm going to do is choose tags, because what we're going to do is tag our bucket, and that will be the scope of this rule. It's going to look for that specific tag. So before we continue, we need to go and define that tag. In S3, I'm going to choose one of my buckets. I'll use the DCT test encrypt. Now, of course, make sure that you have got encryption off. So go to properties. We did enable encryption at some point earlier in the course, but at this stage, it is disabled for me. Now I'm going to add a tag, so let's click on edit, add tag. Mine's going to be classification, and the value is going to be sensitive. So let's save those changes. And back in AWS Config, we're going to put the same key and value here. So once you've done that, let's click on next and just add this rule. So this rule is going to check whether we have encryption enabled, which we know we don't. So it should be non-compliant. But what do we want to do when we find it as being non-compliant? Well, I want to add an actions for auto remediation. So I'm going to manage the remediation here, choose automatic remediation. We're going to choose an action. And if I just type encryption in here, it will then come up with this option, AWS enable S3 bucket encryption. That's going to enable encryption on the bucket. If I just scroll down for resource ID parameter, I'm going to choose the bucket name, and then I need to add in the algorithm, which in this case is going to be AES 256. Now this is going to use Systems Manager automation, and we need a role. So I'm going to go and create a role in IAM. In IAM, I'm going to create this role. For use cases, I want to scroll down and find Systems Manager, then select the first option here, Systems Manager. Allow Systems Manager to call AWS services on your behalf. Click on next. I'm going to type S3 and I'm going to give it full access. Now, of course, you could have a more restrictive policy, but we're just going to use this one for ease of use in this particular exercise. I'm going to go through to review, give it a name. I'm going to call it AWS Config Remediation and then create that role. Now let's search for the role. I'm going to click on it. And I need to copy the role ARN. So I've got the ARN. Let's come back and paste the ARN for our role in here, and then simply save the changes. Now we can see that it has found that our bucket is non-compliant, so that's good. What I'll do now is go to actions and reevaluate, and it's going to reevaluate the rule, and then hopefully it will run the automation. So what we need to do is just give it a couple of minutes and then go and check if encryption's enabled on our bucket. I just gave it a few minutes and I've refreshed my bucket and I can now see that the default encryption is enabled. So that's worked exactly as expected.